Hello students, welcome to the session. So we were dealing on paper 5, that is unit 1, how to solve the linear differential equations. We were dealing how to solve linear homogeneous differential equation, then we were dealing problems on how to solve linear non-homogeneous differential equations, right? So in our previous class we have dealt different methods to find the particular solution. So today we will solve few problems and see how to find the solution for this. So here, as in the previous problem I said, to find the general solution you have to find the particular solution as well as the complementary solution. Sum of that is nothing but the general solution. Clearly it is a non-homogeneous linear differential equation. So now to find the particular solution you have to find the complementary solution first. So we will find the complementary solution, then we will move on to the particular solution. For the complementary solution, what we do, we find the auxiliary equation and we consider this as d square plus 2d plus 5 into y is equal to 0. Now the work is to write the auxiliary equation, that is m square plus 2m plus 5 is equal to 0. Now you have to solve this quadratic equation to get the values or to get the roots. So here what I'll do is I'll use your formula method which you have already learned in your 10th class as well as you are using it from long time. That is nothing but minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2e. So here minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2e. So we have to solve this equation, that time we will get minus 2 plus or minus square root of 4 minus 20 divided by 2. So you will get this as minus 2 plus or minus square root of minus 16 by 2. That is nothing but when you simplify here you will get 4i. Once again 2 is common outside. So when I simplify I'll get minus 1 plus or minus 2i. So we have obtained the roots of this equation. One is minus 1 plus 2i, another one is minus 1 minus 2i. So now the work left is writing the complementary solution. So you have minus 1 here, so e power minus x into plus or minus 2i. So c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x. So this is nothing but our complementary solution. Now the work left is to find the particular solution, that is to find yp. To find the particular solution we have learned many methods, either it may be the undetermined coefficient or shifting of the exponential term, or it may be representing it as w, or different methods we have used, right? So here we are having nothing but d square plus 2d plus 5 into y is equal to e power minus x into sin 2x. So we have already learned how if there is sin x or cos x how to solve, but here we can't use one method and find the solution. So here we have to use two methods. First of all, what we'll do is we will shift this e power minus x. So when we shift e power minus x, we will get e power x into d square plus 2d plus 5 into y is equal to sin 2x. So I have explained already the shifting, how it works, right? F of d into e power ax into f of d into y is equal to one term if it is there, that is nothing but f of d minus a into e power ax into y, right? So here a value is nothing but it is x miss, 1 is the value of a. So we will get here d minus 1 whole square d f of d minus a. So here it is 1, so d minus 1 the whole square plus 2 into d minus 1 plus 5 into these terms get to, you have to write together, that is e power x into y is equal to sine 2x. Now I'll use a capital letter y to represent this term e power x into y. So we'll get here d minus 1 whole square, a minus b whole square formula you have to apply. You will get d square plus 1 minus 2d plus, once again here you can simplify, you will get plus 2d minus 2 plus 5 into capital letter y is equal to sine 2x. Now observe here, capital letter y is nothing but e power x into y. Okay, here observe 2d get cancels, right? So here we will remain with d square here plus 1 plus 5 plus 6 minus 2, you will get it as plus 4 into y. For your convenience, I'll use the, this bracket itself, is equal to sine 2x. Now if there is sine or cos, what we can use, that is nothing but operator method 1 by f of d, or if it is the other method 1 by d evaluation, 1 by d square plus a square into sine ax or sine bx, where a equal to b or a not equal to b, that method also you can use here. So here what we'll do is we'll get yp is equal to 1 by d square plus 4 into sine 2x. So if I substitute here, whether I'll get the denominator term 0? No. If I do f of a equal f of a, here f of a is not equal to 0. So I'll get 1 by 2 square is nothing but 4 plus 4 into sine 2x. So what we'll get here? So that is nothing but 1 by 8 into sine 2x. Sorry, here I'll use one more method, that is nothing but that method also you can use, or you can use one more method, that is here a is nothing but 2, b is also 2, a and b are same. So if a and b are same, then what we can use, it is nothing but, if it is sine, then minus x by 2a into cos. So we'll get minus x by 2 into cos 2x, that is nothing but minus x by 4 into cos 2x. So this is yp. So sum of both the particular solution and the complementary solution is nothing but the general solution of the problem. Thank you.